Good morning, children. Today we are discussing the lesson 4 of class 11 biology, that is Animal Kingdom. In Animal Kingdom, we will be discussing about the basis of classification of animals and the difference between non-chordates and chordates. So now the first part of the Animal Kingdom is the basis of classification of animals. What is the basis of classification of animal? There are certain criteria on which the animals are classified. These criteria can be categorized into five or six steps. The first step of the classification of animal, or the first base of classification of animal, is the levels of organization. Levels of organization of the body. Levels of organization of body. Second one, segmentation of body. Third one, coelom, C-O-E-L-O-M. Fourth one, germ layers or embryonic layers. Germ layers or embryonic layers. Fifth one, symmetry. And sixth one, we can say notochord, N-O-T-O-C-H-O-R-D. So these are the six basis of classification of animals. And let us now come to each step. In the levels of classification of organism, we have three levels. First one is cellular level. Second, tissue level. Third, organ. And organ system level. Organ and organ system level. So based on this complexity of the body, we can classify the organism into cellular level body organization, tissue level, and third one is organ or organ system level. In cellular level of organization, for example, here comes the sponges or porifera. Sponges are coming in this group, sponges. They belong to the phylum Porifera. Phylum Porifera, P-O-R-I-F-E-R-A. The body is only cellular level. It's not turned to the tissue level. That is simplest body organization, right? Tissue level is somewhat highest. That means the tissue formation take place in this group. Example, we can say coelenterates, cnidarians, coelenterates, C-O-E-L-E-N-T-E-R-A-T-E-S, coelenterates, cnidaria, coelenterates also, and cnidarians also, you can see here, cnidaria. Then organ system, you can see the remaining group, that is platyhelminthes, higher phylum. Then all types of organ and chordates, you can say chordates. So there are three systems: cellular level, tissue level, and organ level. Cellular level is the simplest cellular form, no tissue development take place there. Porifera is an example of phylum. Tissues, level organization, tissue formation takes place, like the coelenterates. Then, coelenterates mainly cnidarians. Then, second, organ system, that is platyhelminthes, you can see organ system. Ashelminthes also. organ system, you can see all higher phyla such as Echinodermata, Chordata, etc. So these are the three levels of body organization. Now the second one is segmentation. Body is internally and externally divided into segments. It is also called the metamerism, M-E-T-A-M-E-R-I-S-M. In many types of phyla, for example, you can see arthropoda, you can see Ashamnidus, in many cases you can see the even Annelida also. The body is divided into number of segments. Not necessarily entire body, some parts of the body also be divided into number of segments, as in F2O that belong to Annelida. Okay? Even in cockroach, millipede, centipede, in the arthropods. Okay? You can see such in the body is divided internally and externally into number of segments. It is called the segmentation or metamerization or metamerism. Right. The next one is coelom. Coelom is also called the body cavity. Body cavity. Based on the nature of the body cavity, there are three groups of animals. Acoelomate. Coelomate and pseudocoelomate. Acoelomate are animals without body cavity. No body cavity, no cavity inside the body. Acoelomates are with body cavity. With body cavity. Right? So what is body cavity or coelom then? If you take the cross section of the organism, suppose if you take the cross section, you are taking the cross section of earthworm that belongs to Annelida. We can see a body cavity at the center. So this cavity is seen in between the body surface and gut. Gut means alimentary canal. This is the gut. At the center there is gut. This is the body wall. Body wall. So between body wall, this is the body wall. Okay, I am drawing here is the body wall. The body wall. And this is the gut. That means alimentary canal. At the center you can see there is a cavity. This is the cavity. Okay? This cavity is called the body cavity. So what is body cavity? It is a cavity seen between the body wall and the gut. So animals with the body cavity is called a coelomate, or animals with a true coelom. Example, most of the organisms belong to we can say like Annelida, arthropoda, etc. Echinodermata, all these higher animals are with the coelom. Now pseudocoelomate are animals with the false coelom. Pseudo means false. You cannot see a continuous cavity there. You can see patches of coelom cavity. Suppose the patches are there, this is not a continuous cavity, here are some patches or some small bits of cavities you can see, that is called pseudocoelomate. Pseudocoelomate we can account in some phylum such as Platyhelminthes, Ashelminthes, etc. Right? Now you can see embryonic germ layers. embryonic layers. If you take the cross section of any organism, what is this embryonic layer? Embryonic, in the embryonic stage of animals, the body consists of only some cells, some layers of cells, not the organs. Such animals in their embryonic stage, the body consists of, the embryonic stage consists of certain layers of cells that are called the embryonic layers. We call them diploblastic or triploblastic layers. Diploblastic. Then triploblastic, T-R-I-P-L-O, triploblastic. What is the meaning of diploblastic? In diploblastic, you can see two layers in the embryonic stage. The outer layer is called ectoderm. Ectoderm. E-C-T-O-D-E-R-M, outer layer. And the inner layer is called endoderm. Endoderm. Only two layers are there in diploblastic conditions. Some animal groups are there diploblastic. For example, coelenterates. Diploblastic. Okay, Ctenophora. Example of diploblastic. Coelenterate, C-O-E-L-E-N-T-E-R-A. Coelenterate. Ctenophora. Ctenophora. Some are diploblastic with ectoderm and mesoderm. But in triploblastic condition, there is one more layer in between these two. Suppose I am drawing this is the endoderm, internally endoderm. In between endoderm and ectoderm, there is another layer called mesoderm. Mesoderm. Okay? Mesoderm. So, ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm. These three layers, if are there, then it is called a triploblastic animals. Example of triploblastic, you can see higher phylum such as Annelida, Arthropoda, Echinodermata. So the animals with three layers, embryonic germ layers or embryonic layers called triploblastic, they are ectoderm, mesoderm, endoderm. Whereas in animals with two germ layers, diploblastic, example Coelenterata, Ctenophora, etc. Right? Now we are coming to symmetry. Symmetry. There are two types of animals based on the presence or absence of string symmetry. There are asymmetrical animals, asymmetrical, asymmetrical, and you can say asymmetrical animals are without any symmetry or proportionate arrangement of the body organs. Actually, the word meaning symmetry means the geometrical arrangement of the body parts. That is symmetry. If there is no geometrical arrangement, for example, in poriferous sponges, the body has irregular shape. We cannot get two equal halves. If the body can get two equal halves, when we cut through the center, then it is called a symmetrical element. Okay? But in asymmetrical, there is no way we can get two equal parts. The body organs are in the arranged in the asymmetrical manner, means not in the geometrical proportion. That is found in asymmetrical animals are commonly found in porifera. Porifera. Only in porifera we can say asymmetry. Right? Now, symmetrical animals are two kinds. Symmetrical animals are grouped two. Symmetrical means the body arranged organs are arranged in a geometrical manner. Body organs are arranged in a geometrical proportion. That is symmetrical. That can be bilateral symmetry and radial symmetry. Radial symmetry. In bilateral symmetry, for example, human body. human body, we can get two equal halves, equal sides, right and left sides, only through one plane at the center. So when we cut through the center, we will get the right to equal and the right and left equal halves. Such a symmetry is called a bilateral symmetry. You can found you can see in many types of higher phylums. So bilateral symmetry means that when an organism gives two equal halves, right and left sides, when we cut through the center in only one plane, at the center plane. Whereas in radial symmetry, we can see in the case of sealant plates, when tenophores, there you can see, or even we can see in the other higher phyla as well, you can see the body, suppose in the case of starfish, echinoderms, starfish, I'm drawing starfish, okay, the body can be broken or divided into two equal halves through the center. For example, if I cut this through this plane, you will get right and left half. If you cut through this, you will get right and left equal half. If you cut through this, you will get. So any plane passing through the central axis, this is the central axis, any plane passing through the central axis, you will get two equal halves, then it is called a radial symmetry. So what is radial symmetry? Any plane passing through the central axis, you get two equal halves, any plane. But in bilateral symmetry, only one plane passing through the center, you will get two equal halves. So there are three categories, asymmetric animals without any symmetry, irregular body, porifera. Then symmetrical, bilateral, radial. Bilateral symmetry, you will get two equal halves, the right and left halves, only through one plane, central plane. And in a radial symmetry, you will get two equal halves in any plane passing through. I mean, there are many planes here, one plane, two plane, three plane. So any plane passing through the central axis, you will get two equal halves. That is found in the sealant plates. Now, last of this is notochord. Notochord is the embryonal rod-like structure. In many animals, particularly in the case of, you know, there are two types of animals, chordates and non-chordates. Chordates and non-chordates. Chordates are animals with a notochord in their life. Notochord. Here, no notochord. For example, in any of the phylum, starting from Porifera till the Echinodermata, you cannot see notochord. So the non-chordates belong to 9 phyla, starting from phylum Porifera to Echinodermata. Echinodermata. Here there is no notochord, no notochord at all. So what is a notochord? Notochord is a rod-shaped embryonic structure. Or in the embryonic stages of chordates, you can see rod-shaped structure on the ventral, on the dorsal side of the body. Dorsal side. Dorsal side means upper side, back side. Okay? This belly side is called the ventral side. So dorsal side of the body during the embryonic stage, you can see rod shaped structure. So notochord is the rod like structure seen in the dorsal side of the chordates in the embryonic stage, right? So they are rod like structure seen on the dorsal side of the embryos. In chordates, in non-chordates are totally absent. Notochords are totally absent. So based on this, all types of chordates, starting from fishes, amphibians, reptiles, birds and mammals, all are non-chordates, all are chordates. But non-chordates without the lot of order, that you can see porifera to echinoderm, right? So today, in this part we have studied the basis of classification, levels of organization, that can be cellular level, tissue level, organ and organ system level. Segmentation means metamerization or metamerism, in which body is internally and externally segmented. Coelom means body cavity. There are two types of organisms, coelomates and acoelomates. Coelomates are animals with coelom or body cavity, and acoelomates without the body cavity. Now, embryonic layers, diploblastic, triploblastic. Animals with two embryonic layers, ectoderm, endoderm, is called a diploblastic. Triploblastic are one more additional, in between these two, there is mesoderm. Now, symmetry is a geometrical arrangement of body organs. The animals without symmetry is called asymmetrical animal, as in porifera. Then, in symmetrical animals are all the rest of the animals. Means there are two types of symmetry, bilateral and radial symmetry. In bilateral symmetry, you will get the right and left half only in one plane passing through the center, all in higher animals. Now, when radial symmetry, medium animals, you can see medium phylas, you can see two equal halves in any plane passing through the center. There are many planes we can get two equal halves in this radial symmetry. Now, notochorda is a rod-shaped embryonic structure found in the chordates. The non-chordates are lower animals without the notochorda. That's all today. Thank you.